In this topic, we're going to look at options for HPC or high performance computing, and also kind of the evolution of where it has been and where it's going as it's moving more toward what's known as Azure Batch. So before we do that, let's talk about kind of what HPC is and why you would care about it, or why your customer would want to use it. So by the name, it's pretty self-explanatory, high performance computing, but what are some examples of really intense high performance needs? So when you think about what we're doing right here as an example, and on a very large massive scale, we're recording and we're taking audio and video in, and there's a lot of decoding and compression. If you're doing that on a mammoth scale, like for example for a production studio, for a large TV production, this takes massive amounts of computing power. So that's one example. I have another example. I have a good friend of mine who works for a major amusement park. And I've had discussions with him about this. And he said, the computers they have on premises just don't cut it because they have to do all kind of engineering analysis. So they have to look at all the dynamics of when that roller coaster goes around, what happens if we have 100 people or 500 people or 1,000 people? And what if we run that 50 times a day versus 100 times a day or just 2 times a day? So all the physics and mathematics that goes into that. Another good key example would be something like fluid dynamics. This is pretty interesting too. And here in Redmond, we have a major airline manufacturer. They have to look at how the air flows across that airplane and what happens if they turn direction or if it's cold or if it's hot. These are intensive mathematical calculations that require high performance computing. So those are just a couple examples. So let's take a look here at kind of the evolution of where we've been to where we're going. So we start off here with on-premises, and we can have clusters of these, and we can scale these to reduce runtimes, and we can do scheduling with them. And the next evolution has been, and it's pretty much the same, but we have an HP pack hybrid. So again, we run on-premises, in cloud, or both. So this is kind of getting us into the cloud, with a little integration going on there. But then the next step, so this is where we kind of start going all into the cloud. So we can actually run HPC pack in an instance of infrastructure as a service. So this way we have a little bit more flexible configuration, the patching, the updating that's being handled for us. We don't have to maintain this expensive infrastructure anymore, like I was talking about with my friend who does this. But in doing the HPC pack for IaaS, we still have to maintain and manage that. Just as if I own the servers myself, we're still updating those, we're still patching, we're still monitoring and doing quite a bit of work, administratively speaking. So the evolution then is going to Azure Batch platform as a service. So this is where it's totally all in the cloud, very easy, very fast, and of course we get the hyperscale and elasticity that we get within Azure.
Yeah, and I think this is a good point to point out about platform as a service. From this slide, you can see that basically you're pulling out the infrastructure again, and especially when you're talking about HPC workloads, there's a lot of infrastructure involved here typically. This typically isn't one or two machines, this typically is hundreds of machines, because we need to be able to get that kind of parallel processing performance, and to be able to do that, we have to provision servers. So this is like ideal candidate for something like the cloud. Now, infrastructure as a service can obviously do that, and we can burst into there, which is the scenario you're showing with hybrid. So if we already had an existing on-premises implementation of an HPC workload and we have servers provisioned, great. We can continue to run that, but let's start to kind of burst that up into the cloud and maybe take advantage of some of this PaaS solution, because we don't want to pay for those CPUs at nighttime. When people go home, like your friend with the amusement park, we don't need to have those machines sitting there running, right, consuming power and cost, because we don't need them then. We only need them when we need to do the processing. And I think that's really the key thing about using the cloud with these HPC workloads.
Yeah, and I've had the hard lesson learned before where I fired up not HPC necessarily, but I had a large infrastructure set up in Azure and I just left them running. That clock ticks up really, really fast. So you have to be very careful and cognizant about that. And the platform as a service, like I said, you're just paying for what you use, which is really, really great. So in addition to that, there's a lot of other kind of services that are related to this that you want to take a look at as well and should consider. So just like with everything, we want to take advantage of the richness that Azure provides, not only for batch, where we can go to thousands of VMs and millions of tasks, but also things like the scheduler for invoking services via HTTP or storage queues, taking advantage of web jobs, mobile service jobs, big data with HD Insight, automation and worker roles and virtual machines. So these are a lot of related services that will help to add more value that you can get with Azure Batch, as well as when you have the integration pack with HPC. So that concludes our topic on high-performance computing, integrating with HPC on-premises to the PAC integration with Azure, finally migrating to Azure Batch.